Malkin sending it across, and now the Penguins will advance. Here comes Ben Lovejoy teeing it up. A rebound, scores on the rebound, and the Penguins have struck first. Eric Fair the goal, and Pittsburgh leads 1-0.
A makeshift line for the New York Rangers, and a line that Mike Sullivan kind of put together in game number three, moving Kunitz onto the line with Fair and Malkin. Puck's gonna go in deep. Smart play by Ben Lovejoy. Get it hard on goal. Henrik Lundqvist kind of loses the puck. That's just a routine save. It's a good job by Ben Lovejoy. Henrik Lundqvist has to control that. He doesn't. Lovejoy wins a race against JT Miller, and he puts it to the back of the net. That is not the start the Rangers wanted, and that's not the start they needed. And Henrik's gonna have to be better than that.
Letang again, no shot. Malkin fires it, deflected in! And it's 2-0 Pittsburgh on a redirect in front.
Well, really good poise by the Pittsburgh Penguins on that power play. Hornquist came up to alleviate some pressure, did a good job redirecting the puck, and then they could settle it down again. You see Hornquist 72 go to the front of the net, Malkin with the quick release, and I think that touches Mark Stahl's stick. Let's watch number 18 in the high slot. No, it's Sidney Crosby's stick. My apologies, not Mark Stahl. Malkin shoots it, and right there, Crosby touches the puck and pass Henrik Lundqvist with a nice screen from Patrick Hornquist.
So the power play now 5-for-14. Crosby with his third of the series, second with the man advantage. Hallberg back. Kevin Klein is checked. And here's a break for Connor Sheary. Sheary in, scores! Connor Sheary, and it's 3-0 Pittsburgh.
Speaking of guys that love this building, on March 13th, he had two goals for the New York Rangers. Connor Sheary out of Cushing Academy and also University of Massachusetts at Amherst gets a stick in the lane against Kevin Klein. You talked about the speed quotient being upgraded. It's faster, it's quicker, and it's got better finish on the Pittsburgh side of things because of players like Connor Sheary. He's going to come in high short side on Henrik Lundqvist, not even a doubt. Look at that great stick awareness. We talked about Penguins being harder on the puck. There's Exhibit A.
First Stanley Cup playoff goal. Feed the point. Letang to Malkin. He's shot from long range. And there is a rebound in front. Crosby found it, but too deep in to shoot. Malkin will fire, scores! Another power play goal. And Pittsburgh leads by 4.
This is just Patrick Hornquist at his best. 72 in white, taking hits to make plays, keeping pucks alive, getting out front, and then Geno Malkin, tee it high, let it fly. A double screen, Hornquist is there, Mark Stahl is there, and the puck's touching twine. And you have to wonder if Alain Vigneault is not at some point gonna pull Henrik Lundqvist for the second time in this series to get him ready for their next game in Pittsburgh, which could be a deciding game 5, because I can tell you right now, his team doesn't have him, and I would want this guy fresh for the next game. For whatever reason, the Rangers just don't have it tonight.
Now the Pens power plays out. Trevor Daly to fire it in. Bounce back a couple of games for Daly after a rough go in game 4. There's Dumoulin in front, scores! Malkin's got another on a pretty feed from Brian Dumoulin. So the trigger finger just fine for Evgeny Malkin, and it's 5-0 Pens.
This is just perfect power play hockey. Shoot-in, retrieval, distribution, and finish. Here comes a shoot-in. Here comes a retrieval. Outman them at the point of attack. Great job, Dumoulin, the feed, and the finish. It doesn't get any better than that, Chris. That's just tactically so aware and precise by the Pittsburgh Penguins. Shoot-in, retrieval, outman them, move it, finish it. Perfect.
Boy, they're not just doing a job on the Rangers. They're sending a bit of a message.